The purpose of this screencast is to show an example of setting up and solving material balances on a multi-unit system where we have a liquid-liquid extraction column in series with a distillation column. We'll touch on the ideas of fully labeling a process diagram, degrees of freedom, and setting up a system of material balances. In this problem, we have acetic acid and water that's being fed to the process. These two species are difficult to separate by distillation, so the purpose of the liquid-liquid extraction column is to transfer acetic acid from water into hexanol. And the acetic acid-hexanol mixture is then fed to the distillation column where the acetic acid can be separated. The schematic of this process is shown below. However, we don't have any information that's provided in the problem labeled on the flowchart. At this point, it's important to take a moment to look at what's been given in the problem statement and see how we can apply this information to fully label the process diagram below. After reading the problem statement, it's clear that we don't have any flow rates that have been given. It's important that the total flow rate of every stream is either known or labeled with an unknown variable, so I'm going to go through the process of labeling each of the six streams in this process. All of the compositions that have been given are in weight percent. So I've given a variable of M1 through M6 to represent the mass flow rate of the six streams in the process. The easiest way to fully label the diagram is to go line by line through the problem statement and apply the information that's been given to the appropriate stream. For example, we have some information about the feed to the liquid-liquid extraction column. We know that we have a mixture of 18 weight percent acetic acid and the balanced water that's being fed to the extraction vessel. So we can apply that information to stream 1. Here we're given that the mass fraction of acetic acid is 0.18, and if the balance is water, we know that the mass fractions need to sum up to 1, so the mass fraction of water must be 0.82. The problem states that the other feed to the liquid-liquid extraction column is pure hexanol, which corresponds to stream 2. The water-rich stream that's leaving the extraction column is 99.5 weight percent water. Keep in mind it's the acetic acid in hexanol that's going to the distillation column. So this is the stream M4 that's not being fed to the distillation column. In this stream, the mass fraction of water is 0.995, and we know that hexanol and water don't mix. So without hexanol in the stream, the mass fraction of acetic acid must be 0.005 so that the mass fractions sum to 1. The hexanol-rich extract leaving the extraction column is fed to the distillation column. Here it does not provide any information about the composition, so we're going to have to label M3 with an unknown composition variable to represent the mass fraction of hexanol and acetic acid. So here I've labeled the mass fraction of hexanol arbitrarily with the variable X. And again, we know there's no water in this stream, so the mass fraction of acetic acid must be 1 minus X. We do have some information about the composition of both the distillate and the bottom stream leaving the distillation column. We know the composition of the distillate is 96 weight percent acetic acid and the balance hexanol. The bottom stream is 97.2 weight percent hexanol and the balance acetic acid. So that information has been applied to M5 and M6 respectively. We have one more piece of information that's been given to us. The problem states that 95% of the hexanol that's fed to the extraction vessel is recovered in the bottom stream. So that can't be applied directly to the information on any particular stream, but we can represent that information mathematically. 95% of the feed should be 0.95 times M2, and that's equal to the flow rate of the hexanol in the bottom stream, which is 0.972 times M6. So at this point, we've accounted for all the information that's been provided in the problem statement. Let's take a look at what's being asked in the problem. We need to calculate the percentage of acetic acid in the process feed that's recovered in the distillate. So we want to know how much of the acetic acid going in is being recovered in the distillate here. Before we start writing and solving equations kind of haphazardly, the next thing to do is do a degree of freedom analysis on every system in this particular process. That'll illustrate to us the easiest way to proceed to calculate what's being asked for. All right, I've scrolled down a little bit to make some room to do the degrees of freedom analysis on this process. We can apply this analysis to every system in the process. In this case, we have three. So we have the liquid-liquid extraction column, we have the distillation column, and we have the overall process, So the feed to the process and the outputs to the process. So we'll go through these one by one to see where we should start setting up mass balances to solve for what's asked for. So let's start with the liquid-liquid extraction column and count up how many unknowns we have. We have M1, M2, M3, the composition variable X, as well as M4. So we have 5 unknowns. We can relate these unknowns with material balances. However, the balances need to be independent, and the number of independent mass balances that we can write will always be equal to the number of species that we have. We have A, we have W, water, and we also have hexanol. So we have 3 species in this particular system. We can write 3 species balances that are independent. Keep in mind, we can also write a total balance. However, the total balance is going to be the sum of each species balance. So it is not independent from the 3 species balances. So in this case, we have 3 independent mass balances that we can write. We also don't have any other information that relates any of the variables in the extraction column. So, without any other information, 5 minus 3 gives us 2 degrees of freedom. We're short on the equations that describe these variables. Hopefully we can find another system where we have more information specified. Next, let's take a look at the distillation column. Again, we need to know how many unknowns we have. So the feed to the distillation column is M3, and again, we have the unknown composition variable X. We also have an unknown M5 and an unknown M6. So in this case, we have 4 total unknowns. The number of material balances that we have, or independent material balances, is equal to the number of species. However, in this case, we only have 2. We have hexanol and we have acetic acid. Water is not being introduced to the distillation column, so in this case, we only have 2 independent balances that we can write. And again, in this case, we don't have any other information that's relating the unknowns. So without any further information, we also have 2 degrees of freedom for the distillation column. So let's take a look at the overall system. The system boundaries for the 2 unit operations here, the extraction column and the distillation column, are pretty straightforward. For the overall system, we're concerned with the inputs and the outputs to the process. So to help us visualize the system boundary for the overall process, I'm going to draw a line that intersects the inputs and the outputs to the system. So when we do a degrees of freedom analysis on the overall system, we are only concerned with the streams that are intersecting the system boundary for the overall process. That includes the 2 inputs to the extraction column, the 2 outputs to the distillation column, but it also includes one of the outputs from the extraction column that does not go into the distillation column. So let's see what variables we have. We have M1 going into the extraction column. We have M2. We have M4 leaving the extraction column. We're not worried about M3 because that's internal to the system. We are concerned with M5 and M6. So it looks like we have 5 unknowns. For the overall system, we have 3 species in acetic acid, water, and hexanol. So we have 3 independent balances we can write. We also have another piece of information that relates the unknowns in another equation different from a mass balance. We were given some information about how much of the hexanol going in ends up in the bottom stream. So we have 1 other equation that we can use. So we're left with 1 degree of freedom. However, if you look at the flowchart, you'll notice that there is not 1 flow rate that's specified. We always need to have at least 1 flow rate specified. In other words, we need a basis. So if we assume a basis in one of the streams in the overall process, we can go from 1 degree of freedom down to 0 and start solving for the unknowns. Which flow rate we assume for a basis is arbitrary, and I'm going to use M2 and assume that we have 100. So you can see that if we assume a basis of 100 for M2, that essentially eliminates one of the unknowns, and therefore will have 1 less degree of freedom and give us a 0 degree of freedom system. I've simplified our flowchart here so we can start calculating unknowns related to the overall system. Keep in mind what we're trying to calculate. We want to know what the recovery of acetic acid is in a distillate, which is here, relative to what goes into the process, which is here. So minimally, we need to calculate values for M1 and M5. We can do that using mass balances in the other equation that's been given to us that relates the amount of hexanol in the feed to that in the bottom stream. So we wrote that mathematically using this equation. Since we assumed a basis of 100 for M2, we can quickly calculate M6. So substituting in 100 for M2, gives M6 is equal to 97.7. And here I'm not assigning units with these flow rates. The units are really arbitrary if we're calculating a percentage recovery or a ratio of any 2 flow rates. If we want to calculate values for M1 and M5, we're going to need to relate them by material balances. We can write a material balances on the overall mass. We can also write a species balance for the three species that we have. We'll assume that we're operating at steady state, so all of our material balances are going to have the form of N equals out. If we apply that equation to the total balance, then we have M1 plus M2, which we assumed is 100, is equal to M4 plus M5 plus M6. If we want to write the balance on acetic acid, on the inlet side, we only have acetic acid in one of the inlets to the extraction column. So we have a mass fraction of 0.18 times the total flow rate of M1, and that's equal to the sum of the acetic acid in the three outlet streams. I'll quickly write the balances for both water and hexanol as well. I also substituted the value for M6 that we calculated into the acetic acid balance. With all the material balances written out, we can come up with a strategy that is easiest to solve for the remaining unknowns. So looking at this system of equations, we can see that our H balance here just has one unknown in M5, so we can calculate that first. And with M5 calculated, we can solve any two of the three remaining balances simultaneously. So I'll pick the acetic acid and the water balance. So solving the H balance first to solve for M5 gives a value of M5 is equal to 125. Once we know M5, we can calculate M1 and M4 by solving the acetic acid and the water balance simultaneously. So I won't go through that algebra, but we'll just provide the answers. With all of our remaining unknowns calculated from the mass balances, we can finally calculate what we ultimately want, which is the recovery of acetic acid in the distillate. So mathematically, we can write that the percent recovery is equal to the concentration in the distillate times the flow rate, which was M5, divided by what went into the feed. And the composition that was given originally was 0.18, and our flow rate for M1 is 697.9. So if we calculate that out, the recovery is 0.956, or in percentile, we have 95.6% of the acetic acid is recovered in the distillate.